Alright, so you guys slowly begin to enter the village. You notice that the place is not very busy. However, you do hear the clanging and banging. You know that this is a village dedicated to legendary blacksmiths with quite the reputation to them. So it's not surprising that that's mainly all you hear. Everybody's basically inside working. The place outside is mostly deserted apart from one or two children playing around.
Just to confirm, I've never been here, have I?
No, Gordon actually has never visited this place while you've been with him.
Right. Well, is there anyone out on the street?
It's playing. You don't see anybody, any grown-ups around. Everybody's probably inside since you hear a lot of commotion inside the blacksmith shops.
Well, I suppose I step over to the closest blacksmithing shop to see if anyone's there.
You peek out the window and you see that there's like a blacksmith and his apprentice inside working.
Is there a door? Or is it just open?
Oh, there is a door. It's closed right now.
Well, Alyssia knocks on the door.
As you knock on the door, you hear from inside, "Hey, get the door, boy." The younger apprentice boy runs towards the door, opens the door, and you see that he doesn't seem very interested. But as soon as you sees the drop-dead gorgeous woman from coming to his doorstep from God knows where, he immediately goes, yes, ma'am, how can I, yes, miss, how can I help you today?" You see that he's visibly trying to get the soof and the dirt away from him so he can make himself more presentable.
Oh, Alyssia immediately, follows the flow of the game and fires off a dazzling smile. good day. Rumor has it that there's some trouble going on in this village. Missing people and so forth. Who should I speak to about such things?
Oh, you probably want to see the head blacksmith. Yeah, this, I'm sorry, miss, did you come here to help us?
Hopefully, yes. Although first we need to understand what is going on.
That's wonderful news. I'm sure the others will be very excited to hear that. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm Theron.
Fuck, should I give him my real name?
Do it.
Actually, no, I'm gonna... Hell, wait, what the fuck do you roll in this system for, like, willpower?
Wisdom saving
throw. He's just standing there going, "Pull off,
Roll wisdom saving throw.
Okay, fair enough.
I'd say that's a no.
Nope. You can call me Mina. And these are my friends. And she gestures to the rest of the party.
Names up when you introduce yourself. It's such a lovely name. I knew it. I just knew it. The moment I saw you, I knew you looked like a Mina to me. That's a lovely name to fit such a lovely young lass. And as he is starting to get heated up and probably about to propose marriage, the blacksmith walks up to the door and smacks him hard on the head with his hammer. You're pretty sure that guy probably has a cracked skull now.
What the hell?
Get an arse of yourself, boy, and get back to work. Please back. Bye, Mina. I'll hopefully get to see you later, okay?
Mina just continues to smile, like, "Oh yes, I'm sure. You are a great help. Thank you, love." Meanwhile, inside he's thinking, "What a dork."
Taking the piss out of my poor apprentice.
Vira turns to Blacksmith and smiles at him. To Vira's him as well. Why? Oh my, what on earth do you ever mean?
Enough, lass. I know your type. Don't play games with me.
Well, I don't know how much you overheard of our conversation.
Yeah, follow me. I'll take you to the man himself.
Brilliant.
And he leaves behind his tools and starts heading out so he can take you to the head blacksmith.
Well, Alyssia turns to the group and sort of, you know, cocks her head in the direction of the blacksmith and follows him.
He takes you to what seems to be one of the more presentable houses. You see the guy walk in and he whispers with the guy inside for a bit, probably bringing him up to speed. The blacksmith then leaves and you see that he's starting to go around to gather some people. The guy who he was talking to inside the house, that's presumably the head smith, gets to the door. The guy barely manages to get out of the frame of the door. The door is, shall we say, normal size, and he is anything but. As you can see, he's quite the big fella.
Wait, what the fuck's going on with his eyes? He's totally a demon.
Time. His eyes are a little bit bloodshot, but don't worry about it too much.
Yeah, I was just gonna ask, like, is his eyes glowing or just... No, I assume not.
But they're particularly reddish, like he hasn't slept in like a week or something.
Yeah, probably.
He really manages to squeeze out of the door frame. He looks towards you guys and says, hello there, my name's Jerome. I'm the head smith around here. Over there, Rock says you're here to help. That true?
Yes. And if you find... Since you don't... let me back up and rephrase that.
Words, yes. Last. Why don't you gather your forts, please, come in. There's no need to stand out here. I know it's a shithole, but at least it's clean, I guess.
Well, this fine. I guess I follow him inside.
Was in with her? What are the rest of you guys doing? Are you following?
I'm following, but I'm just staying quiet, yeah. Still kind of upset.
As soon as you guys walk in, the guy casually motions to some chairs and a sofa so you guys can sit down, and he takes a seat as well, taking up his cigar again with a small ashtray, looking heavily. Well, no offense to you lads, but you don't look exactly like military folk to me. Apart from this strong fella. You look alright.
You too.
Well. Head, how many more people are coming?
From what I know, I'm afraid we're it. However, strength is not the only thing that is needed when you're searching for missing people. You might not know me, but I'm sure you know Gordon Steele.
Him. I used to watch his work when I was a small wee lad. He had quite the skill. Shame he was driven out of the village.
He was what?
You cut out.
He was driven out of the village.
May I ask why?
It was a big hassle, really. Gordon didn't wanna stick with the trade. He wanted to be a soldier. So he had quite the spat with his parents. I believe that was the last time they were ever together. They died shortly after he left. Gordon really loved them despite everything. He never got to say his goodbyes to them.
I'm just gonna assume that Gordon's never told me any of this.
He hasn't been back ever since their deaths. Must be quite a sore spot for him.
Did I cut out or something? Hello? Can people hear me?
Hello?
What? I can hear you.
Here we go. Yeah, I can hear both
okay.
of you.
Did you hear what the guy told you, Jerome?
Oh yeah, no, I heard right here. I was asking, I'm assuming that Gordon has never told me any of this.
Yeah, Gordon hasn't told you about any of this stuff.
Right, well, of course he hasn't. Oh my. Well, the only reason I'm mentioning Gordon's name is that is so you can know we come with good intentions.
Know his name, then you gotta be good people. I mean, why else would he send you? I assume he sent you, right?
Not exactly. But if it helps, I have been living with Gordon for the past several years.
No offense, Lass,
I suppose he's the closest thing I have to a father. In a way.
He looks you up and down and says, no offense, Lass, but you don't really seem the type. Gordon is quite the burly man, if I do say so myself. He likes battle and the arts of smithing. You don't seem to be, shall we say, of the same cloth. How'd you get together with him?
That's a long and complicated story. You are right in that we are very dissimilar in many ways, but there are some things he has taught me.
Regarding people is one of them.
Well, sure. There's Alicia says as she real like you know thinks that I knew how to kill people before I ever met Gordon. You know, it was like
he suddenly gets a change of pace and he stomps out his fixed cigar into the ashtray as he exhales the last bit of smoke from his mouth and takes a deep breath. Right, well, honestly, I don't feel much confidence from ya. I don't know how much of help you're gonna be, but considering our dire straits, honestly, I can't afford to be picky. Anything you can do to help would be greatly appreciated.
Yes, well, for starters, I'm afraid we have very little information about exactly what is going on here. All we have been told is that there are people missing.
No, that much. Nobody outside the village seems to know about our plight. The fucking pigs in the capital seem to be keeping it hush-hush. They've always hated us ever since the Warrior King died. Fucking bunch of assholes.
Well, it all depends on who you know and who you talk to.
Give horse in the mouth. Very well then, I'll tell you what I can. Starts to feel a bit twitchy and reflexively reaches out and lights up another cigar. You can probably tell this guy has a problem with smoking.
Yep, and I'm sure this, like the past, I don't know, week's stress hasn't done like anything to help that.
Hey, this is like the 1400s. People don't know that smoking is bad for you yet.
No, like I'm just saying that, you know, like on top of that being like fucking stressed out all the time, he's probably smoking, you know, pretty much every second he's awake.
Since the guy doesn't seem to have a light source ready anywhere around him, he takes up his hammer and actually bangs it hard against the table, which is actually most of his furniture is made out of metal. This guy is clearly fucking metal as fuck. So he bangs the side of the table super hard, deforming it, but he makes a few sparks to light up his cigar. He then just drops his weapon, not caring that his table is completely bent out of shape. About that, okay. I should really stop doing that.
Alicia has, like, doesn't say anything about things. That was fucking weird.
Anyway, let's get down to business, shall we? Over the last couple of weeks, we've had a few people gone missing. People gathering wood, provisions and all that. All of them women, young, beautiful.
Every single one who's missing is a woman.
Age loss.
Sorry, you cut out.
You cut out.
What's your age, lass? All young and beautiful, like you.
I mean, okay. I'm not gonna say this in character, but if necessary, I'll be bait.
Maybe we should pick bait that can actually fight back.
Maybe you should pick Iris, who is literally a monk.
I can turn invisible, fly, and make people decay.
Yeah,
again,
but you need to be
a little more?
Out of
guys, it's getting late. Let's focus, please. You wanna say, Alicia, before he continues?
So is all of the women? All of the women from the village missing?
The women started disappearing. We started to prohibit them from leaving the village so we can keep them safe. The men have started search parties, and we've scoured the forest countless times, but we found nothing. Also, a few of the men sent out to search were found dead. The women are gone, mysteriously disappearing.
Right. Do you have any idea where they disappeared?
One area, lass. It's been all over the forest around here. I'd say in a good 10 or 15 mile radius. They usually don't venture out more than that. We have a few hunting grounds and gathering grounds. Most of the women went missing there. If you have a map, I can show it to you.
Alicia looks around to see if anyone has a map because she...
I don't know who has it. But you know what? It doesn't matter. You take out the map. That's good enough. And he marks a few key locations around the village. They're about an hour or two trip around, so you can basically, it's gonna take you around a day to scour the area.
And the men who was killed, were they also killed seemingly at random or in a specific area?
All over the place, so I couldn't tell you more, but about their death, they kind of weird bug bites or something. They had no blood left in their body, it was all sucked out.
Alicia glances at Vendrik with the like questioning look.
The first suspicion would probably be vampires, but they are more picky about how they bite. He just told you that they have quote-unquote bug bites all over the body, so that doesn't fit the MO of a vampire, so it can be many things.
What I'll do is, do you want me to, I'll reel off a list of things it could be at him. So, best I can do with what I've been told.
Right then. Any of those things have a penchant for hunting young women?
I haven't found the corpses of any of the lasses, so I'm assuming they've been taken. The boys, however, they're all found dead.
Yes, but I'm wondering if whoever killed them is something that has an interest in human women.
It would make sense,
wouldn't it?
Some demons. The same way you'd collect art.
That train of logic there, boy.
Well, as much as I hate to admit it, it makes a certain kind of sense.
Searching party we sent was yesterday. The lads are tired, they need to rest, so I'm not gonna send them out today. So it's gonna be just you out there in the forest. My advice is, if you hear some noise or something, expect trouble.
Can I ask, when was the last disappearance?
I think the last that went missing was about a week ago. Ever since then, we haven't let the women out of the houses.
Wise precaution.
But try telling that to my wife. She threw quite the hissy fit, broke half the furniture, had to repair it from scratch. Crazy woman.
Hmm. Well, Alyssia turns to the rest of the group. Well, we need somewhere to start, and I'm open to suggestions.
I suppose that we might as well start in the forest. Perhaps one of you ladies wants to volunteer to be bait. That might make it easier for the rest of us to track down whatever this is.
Do you perhaps have one of the belongings of the women?
Aye, lad. We have plenty of that stuff. We tried to use dogs to find them. No luck, though.
Tools. We might have more luck.
He walks into one of the other rooms and briskly comes back with a hairbrush with a few hairs on it. Well, it's been a while. If you find nothing, don't feel bad. I've already made my peace about it.
I just nod and take it. I'm basically going to be trying to see if I can magically trace it.
Village, that's probably gonna be hard. Perhaps it might be easier if you go to some of the hunting spots and the gathering areas.
Hard, but you know, it's worth a shot.
Because keep in mind, this woman used to live here, so there's obviously gonna be a lot of traces of her. So you might wanna narrow down that search so it's not so complicated.
So you do it here so you get more familiar with the particular strand, and then it will help you follow
not
it.
Do it. I'm not sure if you're using a spell. If not, I'm gonna have you make a roll. Is that okay?
I have locate creature, which is literally a spell specifically designed to do that.
Well, there you go, Vira. Say it in character.
I can't say it in character. I'm gonna die. I'll say it telepathically. I'm just gonna telepathically tell Vendrik, if you give me that, I might be able to locate her. Here, literally, it's a spell.
Google! I cast Google.
Gotcha.
For fuck's sake.
That is the one I was talking about. And leave the room and gesture for Vira to follow me.
Alright.
Well, it seems that this spell actually has a lot of limitations, distance and water, so right now you will not be able to sense where the target is, but you're starting to see branching out paths towards the gathering grounds. So you can follow one of the leads.
Yeah, So
he sees you out the door and says, try not to get yourself killed, lads. We have enough deaths here, we don't need any more.
Yep, so me and Vera are just gonna start bloodhounding.
Right. I want you guys to make me... insight, a perception, and a survival roll. One of you picks a roll. So I want one person to make me an insight, one person to make me a perception, and one person to make me survival. One person cannot make two rolls, so one each.
I have insight because I have proficiency in insight.
I'll take the survival.
I'll take perception. I've got high wisdom, and
I got 9 perception. So
yes.
Boy.
Right. So. Because your survival is low, I'm gonna say that you're gonna take an extra hour on your journey until you're sure what you're doing. But with your insight and perception and the spell that Vira cast, you'll have no problem finding where your target is and be and confidently going on the right track. So you did quite a lot of things well here, so this is actually gonna skip a lot of the searching and investigation. So good job, guys.
Woo, bloodhound!
Turns
out it doesn't just work for cinders.
Hashtag step back and let the casters handle this.
It takes you about 2 hours to get to your destination. It takes you about 2 hours to get to your destination, and then about another hour until you guys are at a small cliffside at one of the edges of the forest. You hear running water somewhere nearby on the right. And in front of you, the trail is leading forward. However, it's a straight up wall climb. There's literally a huge boulders in front of you.
All right, so there's boulders.
Obviously, climbing is for plebs. Misty step.
Or you could just dimension door up to the top.
Because you don't feel the trace going up, you feel it going forward.
Oh, okay. It looks like there's it's a wall. We gotta find the entrance to the secret tunnel or something.
Can I
attempt to punch the wall?
My eyes and meditate, see if I can find any arcane traces.
Patrick, as you meditate, you indeed start to feel some faint magic in front of you. However, that quickly disappears as Iris punches in front of her, and she punches thin air. You hear the Dark Soul sound.
I'm gonna put that in, by the way.
Yes. There's a huge cat.
Well, I just wasted a good roll for nothing then, I guess.
You're like, you're both of you are like on the ground. We shall meditate. Yeah, it's alright.
You stands a huge cave entrance, and the cave entrance seems to be quite well maintained. There don't seem to be any animals or anything living here. Not only that, but apart from some spider webs, there's nothing inside.
Ooh.
Also, my mouse just died, so give me a second. I need to restart real quick. While you guys are deciding
it's a
what's going to happen, I'll be right back.
We're gonna be ending soon.
It's probably a male spider demon too. He wants a bunch of waifus.
I'm sure we're gonna find a harem, but they're all like ridiculously looked after.
Wait.
His venom is just like mind control, like something that'll make him like love potion. He has like love potion venom. It's a spider succubi.
Cocoons. If it's a spider, they're all spun up in cocoons. So.
Yeah, it's a spider succubus.
I hear somebody hoping.
What?
Not to be an ass, but if it's a male, it's an incubus.
It's a spider incubus. Whatever, same difference.
I still say it's to gonna be like it's just gonna be normal. Like they were kidnapped, but they decided to stay on their own because they're so well looked after.
As you guys start walking inside, the cave begins to spread out. You see multiple hallways and such beginning to sprawl out. However, on the side ones, you see that there's a lot of cobwebs and spiders lurking about doing their busy work. What seems to be the main way forward, however, is mostly neatly kept with few spider webs. So you definitely know which way is forward inside this maze. For now, by the way, you're gonna need a light source soon.
I'm free to fire into my hands.
I got this, fam. I got you, fam. Give me a second.
I was about to ask. Like,
I got you, fam.
Is it too? Wow, like so much of sneaking. Anyway, like I was about to ask, is it too dark for dark vision?
No, you're fine.
No, dark vision is for great. When it's really dark.
No, yeah, but I'm assuming that dark vision actually requires like some light.
No, it's specifically for when there is no light.
Don't worry about it.
Wow. Okay. That's cool. And slightly overpowered.
You guys continue forward.
Get rid of it and superior dark vision.
Yeah. The main cavern which you're following, the main cavern piece, it starts getting webbed up, so you start stepping into spider webs and all that.
Told you it was a spider incubus. It might not be an incubus, but it's definitely spidery.
Hear a voice somewhere in the caverns because of the echo and the split passages.
No, I'm not.
However, you guys cannot make out where it's coming from. You can just hear the voice. Ah, visitors, how nice of you to join me. I must admit, I will make a poor host as I did not expect you. But what the hell? Come in. Join me. Almost there now. You're so close.
I have a feeling this is gonna end in us getting eaten.
That
not
is
in
so,
character.
That is so wrong. Not in character.
Okay, yeah, I don't know, man. Let's just keep going. I mean, there's nowhere to go. The only way out is through.
Do I sense anything with my passive 19 perception?
There's a lot of scurrying spiders around you, everywhere.
Yeah, we're still going. I'm just like,
Alyssia, like, turns to Vendrik. Hey, Vendrik. Do you know of any spider demons?
Do I know of any spider demons?
Yes, that's what she asks.
Think of about 5. Why?
Still heading inside.
Because I just have one of those feelings. A bad feeling.
Yeah, I'm still walking. Like this hashtag YOLO.
They're all wait to fire.
Yeah, eventually you guys start reaching the end of the long cavern and it splits out into a huge inner cavern. The ceiling is probably a good 10 meters high. It's pretty damn spacious. There's a lot of stalactites all over the place and a lot of spider webs, and there seem to be a lot of other tunnels linking to this area. So you have no idea how you literally can't tell just how massive this entire area is. You finally came. Welcome, welcome. It's so good to see you. I've been just dying for some fresh company. Since I'm assuming that you're probably one of the guys leading the pack, some kind of liquid drips down on your shoulder.
Who?
At first you think it's some water from the cavern, but when you look to your shoulder, you see that the drops falling on you are red.
Oh, wait, who is this? Me? Vendor? Who? I can't hear you.
Varian! Some red liquid is falling on his goddamn shoulder.
Oh, okay.
Just gonna kind of look at it and go, sort of having, like, wiped my hand with it, just hold it up and go, hey guys, we seem to have a problem, and show the blood on my hands.
I'll just look up.
Same.
Alyssia expects that looking up is a bait. And looks everywhere except up.
As you guys look up, you trace to where the red liquid fell from. I humble a bolt. Now, since you came all the way out here, let's have some fun, shall we?
Oh, God.
What the fuck am I even looking at?
It's a bunch of naked women.
Well, yes, that I can see.
Can I quickly change myself into a guy?
Because that is going to be it for our session. Woohoo! We did it!
Well, hey! What? Twice?
You got two next.